大谷選手の2打席連続ホームランなどで3対0でロイヤルズに快勝したドジャース。しかし7回にベッツ選手が手にデッドボールを受け、そのまま退場となり、その後の検査で骨折していることが判明し、長期の離脱となることが分かりました。試合後のベッツ選手のインタビューと MLB ネットワークの番組でその影響についてコメントされていました。
Mookie, it was really scary seeing you go down like that after being hit by a pitch. Just, did you know kind of immediate reaction that it wasn't going to be a good result after this x-rays?
No, I didn't know. I mean, probably the first time I'm getting, I think that's the first time I got hit in the hand, so I wasn't sure. I just went numb and it hurt, so unfortunately it's broke, but then really we can do now.
How do you just kind of handle what's going to be next for you, just knowing it's not season ending, but it is going to take some time to let it heal before you can come back?
I'm not sure. I'm honestly not sure. Obviously, I'll be watching the boys, cheering them on, but other than that, I mean, it's just kind of rest, maybe use it as a mental break, and be ready to go whenever it heals up.
What did you see on the pitch? Can you talk about the pitch?
Oh, I mean, you just got to...stay in there. I mean, you can't be scared, you know. Got to stay in there, and especially with a guy with a pretty good slider. So, yeah, I was just kind of up and in, and I was holding my ground, and unfortunately, it hit me in the hand.
Have they given you a general timeline at all?
Not really. I'll go see the doctor tomorrow, and then we'll know more. But right now, it's just let it heal.
Let's begin, though, with Mookie Betts and how this changes the Dodgers completely.Or does it? Is Miggy Rojas going to be able to slide in and be the everyday shortstop? And with Shohei and Freddie and Will Smith and Teoscar Hernandez, they'll be just fine in the lineup.
Not taking anything from Rojas, he's going to be as good as, or maybe better than Mookie at shortstop because he's experienced, he has the tools, he's always been a great glove. But there are so many intangibles in Mookie Betts that you can't replace. And...I don't know that Rojas is going to have the bat, he's going to have the speed, he's going to have the versatility to move anywhere they move him. Mookie is just one of those players that you can't replace. One elite talent that you don't find every single day. And the Dodgers are pretty much built around Mookie. Everything that you see with Freddie Freeman, with Otani, with Smith, with all the players that they have and the way that the lineup entirely is structured.It's around Mookie Betts and what he can do and what he can supply. It's going to be really difficult for the Dodgers to find that piece that's going to probably get close to what Mookie might be. And if you have me thinking, I'll probably say one of those names might be Bobby Chet.
Bobby Chet.
Yeah, it might be one of those guys that if the Toronto Blue Jays are going to trade, I don't know that they're going to do it right now. So they're going to have to stick to Rojas and Kike and...I don't know, some of the guys that they have, Gavin Lux, I don't know that he can probably fill that gap they need.
Would you make a deal for Paul DeJong? You got to believe he's available.
No, I don't think so. Rojas is probably at the same level as
Well, more DeJong. Power. More
DeJong
power
has for... more power, but the defense.
What about Tim Anderson with the Marlins?
Tim Anderson, that could be another guy that could probably fill some of the holes, but...Not to the, near the level of Mookie Betts and not near, you know, to the intangibles that Mookie brings with the running the bases and with the versatility of going to the outfield. Rojas is more suited to probably play a little bit in the outfield on Kike than probably yeah. Anderson would.
替えの効かないオンリーワンのプレイヤーであるベッツ選手の長期離脱。ドジャースにとって大きな出来事になりました。ショートの守備はロハス選手で埋められそうですが、リードオフとしてのベッツ選手の離脱はかなり影響が大きいです。今後のトレードでも大きな動きが出るかもしれません。しっかり養生し早期の復帰を願っています。